Hello everybody, let me show you the latest version of my goal setting and life planning spreadsheet. This is version 3 and you can download the copy from the link in the description, but let me show you how it works first. Okay, so a couple of weeks ago, I gave you version 2 of this spreadsheet, right? But since then, I've augmented it. So I've got a life coach and a property investing coach called Alex Louise Thomas, and I'm part of a mentorship group. We're based in South Wales. And as part of it, we meet up every month, we do conference calls, and we're investing in property together. But it's a very holistic group. Alex makes us work on all the areas of our lives, not just business. She makes us look at every aspect of our lives so we get our entire life on track, right? So and what I've done, I've incorporated some of her sort of goal setting framework into this spreadsheet, right? If you want to find out more about her, you can go to financialfreedomwithalex.com. Okay, so let me show you. So my basic version that I gave you a few weeks ago was these first three tabs at the bottom, okay? The dashboard, the map, and the actions. And I'll just quickly run over it. On the dashboard, you choose the time frame you want to work with for your goal setting. So we want to choose today's actions. That's immediate stuff to work on. But we also want to set our one-year goals. Let's say, just example, 10-year goals. You can choose your own. And let's choose the areas of life we want to work on. Physical health. It's up to you, whatever is important to you. Business, relationship, and let's just say project one. It doesn't matter, it's arbitrary. It's up to you. So if you go onto the map page, what happens now, it automatically maps out those timeframes and those categories. So there's today's actions, 1 year and 10 year. And there's those categories that you ticked. And the idea is you just fill in the boxes and you put whatever your goals are. It's nice and simple, okay? Nice and simple. On the third tab, it'll automatically list the ones from the action column. Okay, so that was what I started with. Now the new tabs in version 3 is Alex's model, okay? So it's up to you. You can use both or pick and choose. You can do whatever tabs you want to do, right? So the first one is values. Now, down the here on the left-hand side is a huge list of values, the things in life that might be important to you. And the idea is we're all different. Some of us value security, some of us value adventure, some of us value family, some of us value status. And there's no right and wrong. It's just like whatever floats your boat, you know, whatever excites you, just tick the box, you know. Now, this list is inherited from Brené Brown, who's a public figure, sort of an emotional intelligence, sort of life coach, motivational speaker, spiritual teacher kind of woman. You can find her on YouTube. And she's got this list of values, right, that Alex sort of incorporated in as part of her course. So let's just take an example, right? My eyesight's terrible. I got to lean in. Give me a second, folks. I'm one of those people who won't wear glasses, but really should. So let's say what's important to me. So achievement, I'm just going to pick a few at random. There's intuition. I like that one. Security, self-expression, success. Responsibility, respect. I'm not giving it too much thought. I'm just showing you the example. Let's put health, leadership. I'll just choose a couple more. Knowledge, justice. Okay, there's our example list. Now, what happens is the ones that I ticked automatically appear in this next column, right? The idea is what you're going to do now is choose the top five that really matter to you most. So I'm going to tick achievement, leadership, success, self-expression, and security. Okay, so these are the ones that we're boiling it down now. We're kind of whittling down the list, okay? And from those, we're going to choose the top two that really matter to us. So I'll say success and self-expression. And there's your final two that are most important. Okay. Now let's go on to the next tab. You can really learn a lot about yourself just from going through this process, you know, because it just makes you think, doesn't it? And it makes you realize why you do certain things and why certain things are important to you and why certain things don't interest you. You know, I have no interest in cooking. None. Doesn't interest me. I don't want to do it. I don't want to learn to do it. To me, it's a waste of time and it's below me. That's how I feel about it, right? I've got better things to do that are more productive. That's how I feel. There's no right and wrong. Somebody else enjoys cooking. They don't enjoy computer programming. I enjoy computer programming, you know? Somebody else doesn't enjoy... What else do I do? We've all got different values. There's no right and wrong. Now we're on the Wheel of Life section. So, each area of life on the Wheel of Life, you're going to give it a score from 0 to 10 of how well you feel like you're doing in that area. So love and romance. I'm single. I'm going to give it a 2. Social friends. Yeah, I'm pretty good on that. I'll give it a 6. It's subjective. You know, somebody else's 6 might be your 9. You know, it doesn't matter. Just whatever comes to mind. Don't overthink it too much. Family. Well, I don't really have family. Not really. Well, I've got my parents and sister, but I don't have my own family, so I'll give that a 2. Home. Don't know what that means. Well, home life. Well, I'm a lodger, so 2. Not looking good so far, is it? Fun and leisure. Yeah, 5. Personal development. I'm high on that. I value that. Physical health. Yeah, I'll give that an 8. Mental health, yeah, I'm on top of that. I give that an 8. Contribution, that doesn't mean anything to me. I give that a 1. Business, work life, yeah, give it a 6. Wealth, finances, I'll say 4. Okay, I didn't overthink it. I just put what came to mind. Now, out of this list, here's a pie chart. Now, this is not ideal because what we really want is equal divisions with the slice of the pie sort of being reduced to the level, but I can't do that on this spreadsheet, so it's just represented like that. Never mind, we'll get over it. Now, what Alex recommends is you're going to choose the top 2 areas of life that are the biggest priority to you. What matters the most? Okay, for me, love, romance, and wealth, finances, okay, so they're my top 2, right? That's the wheel section done. Now, going to go on to the mini milestones. These are basically your 12-month milestones, where you want to be in 12 months. So, and you're going to put mini milestones for each month. Okay? Now, here in this box, this is what Alex called future fulfilled. I don't know where she got that phrase from. She probably learned that from, you know, someone else, because we all learn from each other, don't we? You're gonna write a statement about how you want that situation to be in 12 months from now. So if it's your business, you're gonna declare it. How, describe it. Describe what it's like to live that reality with the goal complete in 12 months. So I put 1 there for love and relationship, 1 there for finance. And then you're going to fill out each month the mini milestones. Okay, that's it. Don't overthink it. It is what it is. The last and final tab is breaking it down each month. So on this tab, I've put December 2019. And these are the actual action steps week by week. This is your actual to-dos that you're working on in order to fulfill the next milestone. So whatever I put in January, my December action steps are going to be orientated towards, hang on, let me think about this. Or no, maybe you can just do the same month. So whatever, you know, whatever, figure it out, right? Your brain works, doesn't it? So figure it out. You're going to put your action steps there. There's a column where you can put the due date. And every time you complete a task, you can use the tick box. Okay, that's it. You got your month goals, you break it down into your immediate action steps. That's it. And each month you're going to create a new, the month action steps, you're going to create a new one. So when you get to January, you're going to copy this, and that's going to be your January sheet. And then you're going to change the dates and make sure it's all right. and you're going to fill in these action steps every month, and you're going to stay on top of it and make sure you're achieving all your milestones and all your goals. Okay? Isn't that cool? Isn't that cool? So you can download this. The link is in the description. Thanks for watching, everyone.